Well, I'm going to kick it off. Good evening. How are we doing? Are we ready to shovel no snow on Sunday? Good. Good. Well, welcome to the 12th annual celebration. This would not happen if it were not for you. So thank you, thank you, thank you very much. It is because of you that ILAP is engaged in some noble causes, so we will celebrate that tonight. Before we do, I have to thank CTN, Community Television Network. I've been informed that I'm on a 5-second delay because sometimes I just get very excited and say crazy stuff. But we will be able to watch this on Time Warner Cable Channel 5 in the Greater Portland area, and also on demand on their website, which is ctn5.org. I want to thank them personally for taping this event. The other thing they have done is they are actually live feeding this to one of the Trump rallies as a... I wear my politics on my sleeve, yes, sir. But they're live feeding it to show how sane some people can be in the sea of insanity. So, hear, hear. So, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Kerem Durda. Born in Pakistan of Turkish parents, came to the United States when I was 17 and a half. Went to an all-Benedictine Catholic college, which I did not know at the time. It is very funny. Over beer one day, I will tell you the story. Came over to UNH, met my wife in 1993. So, it's a good day. And settled in Maine. Because I was born in Pakistan of Turkish parents, came to the United States, and have been fortunate enough to work and run a couple of global companies, I am the poster child for Homeland Security, what not to do. I can give you secrets about Homeland Security that you may not know of, including if you ever fly out of Manchester Airport and you get agitated because you feel you've been picked on, or because of some ignorant comment, there's actually a timeout section. I know, because I've been in the timeout section many a time. Many a time. So I'm blessed with three kids, a sophomore and a boy, and two girls in the 7th and 5th grade. I am under strict orders by them and my dear wife not to embarrass them. I can embarrass myself, but I cannot embarrass them. So, that is my story, and I'm sticking to it. If you do Google me, you'll find out some interesting stories about me, but one interesting thing is there have been 68 different versions of my last name, inclusive of the all-famous, can I please speak to Mr. Dirtbag? Which creates an interesting dynamic because it's mostly the telemarketers, and then I get to say to them, what is your name? And that's really, that's when the wall breaks down, and they start talking to you, which is interesting. So I want to take the opportunity to introduce a dear friend of mine, the executive director of ILAP. She has been working since 2000 to better lives. She's passionate, articulate, has concern and care, is a decent human being, and I'd like her to come up here and say a couple of words. Thank you. Sue.
Thank you, Karen. Well, good evening, and welcome to ILAP's 12th annual CeleSoiree. Thank you all so much for coming this evening. Thank you for supporting ILAP, for supporting our immigrant community, and for helping to make this another sold-out event again this year. Thanks so much. First, I'd like to thank our event sponsors and our raffle donors. You can find them listed in our program. If you see them tonight, please thank them. Many have been donating year after year, and without them, we would not have a CeleSoiree, so we really appreciate that support. Thank you. I'd also like to recognize our incredible Planning Committee, and especially Sally Newhall from Seaglass Events, who's our event coordinator, our development director, Loretta Prescott, Olivia Orr on staff, and all the incredible volunteers who helped put this event together tonight. Thank you so much. And a special thank you to Karim Durdog for being our MC tonight. We really appreciate that. Thanks so much. And so every year, ILAP serves over 2,000 people, helping them gain legal status. Another 1,000 people come to our education and outreach events. And so how many people can you imagine it takes to get this work done? Well, at ILAP, we have just 9 staff and over 200 volunteers who help support them to get all this work done. And so if you're a member of ILAP's staff, board, a pro bono attorney, or volunteer, can you please stand up? Super, thank you. Come on. That's incredible, isn't it? Without these people and without ILAP, there would be no place for low-income immigrants to go in Maine for help getting through that complex immigration process so that they can get the legal status they need so they can stay in the country and build their new lives here in Maine. ILAP's staff and board are really the heart of the organization. It's their dedication and their commitment to ILAP's mission that really make ILAP such an amazing organization, and we really appreciate everything they do. I'd also like to recognize somebody else who really was the heartbeat that started ILAP. Beth Stickney was ILAP's founding executive director. I know she's in the room here tonight. She can stand over here. Beth is recently back from Italy, and we're so glad to have her back in Maine. Beth had the foresight and the vision 23 years ago to start a pro bono project with a few volunteer attorneys. I think a few of them are in the room this evening, representing asylum seekers. And as the immigrant community grew over the years, ILAP has grown as well. In 2000, we became a staffed organization. And we now, as I said, have 9 staff and 200 volunteers serving 2,000 people a year. So it's really incredible. And ILAP was really the foundation of what has now become a network of organizations, advocacy groups, service providers, leaders in the business and government who are all supporting and welcoming our immigrant community. So we really, if it weren't for Beth, we wouldn't have ILAP, and this would be a very different place. So we really appreciate and gratitude for everything that she's done and for her continued support and advocacy for the immigrant community. Thank you. And what better time for us to gather together and celebrate our immigrant community? When you can't open a newspaper, you can't turn on the TV or the radio without hearing ugly words of anger and fear and hatred and racism. These are poisonous words that encourage dangerous action and response. But we can counter that intolerance with positive words of celebration, support, and inclusion. An action that promotes a community where we celebrate and we appreciate our diversity and we accept and understand our differences. And by being here tonight, you're part of that message because you understand the important role that immigrants play in our community. You understand the diversity and culture they bring, the new ideas, the skills and the talents that they bring to our workforce. They bring diversity and vibrancy to our community. And that diversity is what is and what always will be part of our society. A real critical part. So thank you all. And take this energy with you. Take it back with you to talk with your family, your friends, and your community, people in your community, because celebrating our immigrant community here tonight and then outside the doors after we've left is the way that we will be able to overcome that fear and hatred and racism that we see out there. We really appreciate you being part of this celebration tonight to help celebrate and support ILAP. To support our immigrant community. We have a really exciting program ahead of us this evening. We have Akwaba Ensemble, which is a West African dance and drum group. We're really thrilled to have them here. We also have many others who've helped to make this a beautiful and delicious evening. We have Empire, Taco Trio, and Jewel of India, and Coffee by Design. We also have Dogfish at the Bars, Adam Burke, who helped with coaching, AV Technic with the light and sound, Adele Nagoy, who had the beautiful outfits you've seen on our raffle volunteers, and of course, Pandora, who's brought us once again these beautiful lights. We really appreciate that. So I hope you all had a chance to buy some raffle tickets. I do want to let you know that we will be picking the winners at the end of the program this evening, and you do need to be present in order to win. So make sure you hold on to those tickets and listen in at the end. We also have some dessert and coffee that will be following the performance. So I hope you enjoy the evening. Thank you again so much for coming, and I will turn things back to Karim. Thank you.
Sue, in confidence, told me that she's thinking of running for the governorship. I say yes. It's about time, actually. A woman who believes in immigration rights? I don't know. I think it's time. I am thankful for ILAP to select me for this honor. Loretta told me that she saw me on hosting Turkish Idol, the pop show. I don't know. I think she watches way too much TV. Especially international TV, I don't recommend it. The soap operas are really droll and boring, and they go on and on for years. So I wouldn't recommend watching Turkish TV. Pakistani TV, whole different story. So, hey, look, it's time. So I want to welcome the Akamba Ensemble out here. You know that music is a part of life. It's a rhythm that keeps us going. It gets us through some tough times. It helps us celebrate some good times. I hope that you enjoy them. I hope you clap with them and you dance with them, because if you don't, I'm coming around you and we're going to do it together. So let's give a warm hand out.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
you clap again. I just texted my friend Justin Timberlake. I said, move away. The new boogeyman is in town. Do you see that dancing? I'm a firm believer. We listen to that music, we'll at least live 2 years longer with the energy. Thank God, that was... I know, I've been told I can't move my feet because I'm supposed to present, but I can't help it. Can't help it. Come on. I mean, like, boogie. God, you guys were good! Yes! So, you know, energy is about telling stories. Stories. And, you know, I am one of those many, many, many millions of people that have stories about how I came to make a life in the United States, thanks to the nobility and grace of many, many people. And I think there's nobility and grace in what ILAP does. There's nobility and grace in the life we try to create. Whether it's trying to survive the visa immigration, the visa process or the work permit process, or having somebody advocate for us, I strongly believe to the bottom of my core and my dancing feet that what ILAP does is noble and graceful. It helps us create stories, yes. It helps us create stories. It helps us tell our stories. And we have a special, special speaker who is going to tell us her very, very valuable story. So I welcome Carmen Sanchez. Please, thank you.
Hello. I am going to tell you my story and how Ayla helped me. I came to United States for love. I have to leave Peru when I own my own business. I decide to take a risk and leave everything behind. When I got here, unfortunately, the thing changed. I found myself in abuse marriage. In that time, I feel alone, trapped. I lost a sense of what I was. One day, a nurse was able to see in my eyes the pain what I was feeling. So she was able to help me to go to the family crisis. Thus, family crisis referred me to set an appointment with ILAP. When I walked to ILAP, at that time, I didn't have any scar, any bruise, nothing to prove the pain. The only half what was my heart had. But the lawyer, Ayla, could open my heart. She listened to me carefully. The most important thing, she believed me. Eventually, I trust her, was able to tell her my story. It was really, really hard to tell her all the detail. Also, the process with immigration was long, but Jennifer was there with me throughout. Finally, was we able to get my legal status sent to ILAP, I smiled, started to cry. ILAP means to me protection, support, home. In other words, ILAP means to me one community, one family. Finally, I was able to obtain my legal status. Guess what? Today in the morning, I became American citizen. This is the proof. Citizenship means to me a lot because it gives you equal right. I feel that I am part of this land. I have a role to play. I have a big commitment. And also, I feel this is home now. The most important, I think, even more precious, I am here as my own person. Thank you, ILAB. Thank you, Susie Rocher. Thank you, Jennifer Bailey. Estoy muy agradecida por tu maravilloso trabajo que has hecho y voy a estar eternamente agradecida a ti. I said in Spanish because I speak Spanish. Actually, I speak Spanglish. But I said thank you very much, Mrs. Jennifer Bailey, for your amazing and extraordinary work. I am going to be grateful for the rest of my life. Thank you, all of you, for letting me to sharing with you my story. I appreciate it a lot. Thank you.
I want to thank her for her story. I want to thank her because it's not easy sometimes to tell our stories. It takes courage. It takes courage on your part to listen to us and give us a little space in your lives. It takes courage from our side to articulate things that sometimes are very, very tough to articulate. And so we are gathered in this space to share each other. And I'm incredibly proud that you are now an American citizen. Yeah. Incredibly proud. When I became an American citizen shortly after 2001, prior to that, my wife and I went for an interview, which I think lots of us go to interviews. And I remember the interviewer saying to my wife, "So who is this alien relative?" Because on the forms it says alien relative. And my wife, dear wife from South Portland, Wellesley graduate, you know, tough, she says, "He is not my alien relative, he's my lover." I was like, yeah. The interviewer pretty much said, "We're done. Goodbye. You're approved." So, the other curious thing is that, you know, I'm a soccer fanatic. And so I'm blessed with a couple of occasions seeing the United States and the Turkish national team play together. And I must say that I stand up for the anthem for both countries. I wear the jersey of the U.S. team in the first half and then of the Turkish team in the second half. It's not divided loyalty, it's just you have more fun by having two sets of jerseys. And so in that way, I want to thank on the behalf of all of us, for making us part of your fabric, because it is our fabric. And I don't think we should let anyone tell us any differently. I believe that. So, now we're going to do some fun stuff, because ILAB does a lot of work and we have to help them. Stuff they do isn't for free, it costs money. I don't know if you realize this, but they actually cannot apply for federal grants because what they do, the work they do is with undocumented human beings. Isn't that interesting? They cannot apply for federal grants to help other human beings. But we can get federal grants to do research on mice. I find that curiously strange. But we are going to do a reverse auction. And we are going to raise, I kid you not, $25,000. We're going to raise $20,000, and then a dear friend of ours, Imad Khalidi, who is the CEO and president of Auto Europe here in Maine, has pledged another $5,000 as a match. I have been asked not to leave the stage till that happens, at great personal risk. I'm also a great poker player. I can take my clothes off for money. I urge you not to try me, because for a good cause, I will do so. So the way it's going to work is we're going to start with some large amounts, and then we're going to work ourselves down. And in the course of that, other than public shaming, the only guide that I have, the only leverage I really have on you is on your good conscience, and have some giggles and laughs at the same time. So, just as a point of fact, and I wanted to read this out, asylum seekers taking their case to the government without an attorney see an 88% denial rate. 88%. When ILAPs get involved, it's 97% success rate. So think about that. That's a huge impact on human lives that ILAP has. So, in that vein, we're going to start out for $1,000. I am seeking a whole bunch of people to donate $1,000 each. Now, I know some of you, I will not call upon you yet. So, there are some dear friends. So, who do I have leading the charge? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I didn't even have to undo a button. Thank you. Three, four. Thank you. God. This is amazing. I want to thank them. Please. Let's thank them. Thank you so much. I don't know, maybe we need to bring the dancers again, screw a little. Did you see that move the guy, I'm saying, did you see that move he had? I mean, I got jeans on, but, that was amazing, the way he was. I got it, then he went. It takes, here. Conditioning workout, I think there's a DVD right there, African rhythm music. I don't know. Here's another interesting fun fact. This is really interesting. So when the unaccompanied child crisis happened in 2014, ILAP was the one who helped the kids. Just think of it. ILAP helped the kids during that 2014 crisis to have them safe harbor here. So now we have a potential second, third generation thanks to ILAP's work. Just think about the impact. That's a multiplier impact. There's an ancient Talmudic saying, you help one life, you help a universe. It's amazing. I have been told that due to some system failure, not to be blamed on Microsoft, we need everybody who pledged $1,000 again. And we're not going to blame Bill Gates for this. Yeah? Did we get it?
Can you say the numbers so that you can write them down?
242, 235, 328, 117, 314, 234. Adam, yay! I can't pick on the guy anymore, yes! Thank you.
One more.
Keep your clothes on, right?
You just introduced me to your wife this evening. So, yes. We need one more. All right, fine, I'm going with the, I start small. I'm serious. One more. I I'll sing, yeah, oh, 198, yes. I was gonna crack into an old Urdu romantic song. I will save that for next time. I do sing, very, you know, thanks to YouTube, I can catch up on all my old Urdu and Turkish songs. Oh, hot diggity dang, 297. Thank you. Ye naam aur tera kaam dono kitne milte julte hain tera naam nahi lunga magar tujhko shaam kahunga. Alright, so there'll be more later. I do sing some Journey songs, remember? Journey? Alright. Don't stop. Okay. I'm having a good time. I hope you guys are too. So, next, we are at the level, another level, and I may join you guys. But before I do that, we're going to the next level of $500. Now, I want to give you a sense of what $500 does. In Pakistan, actually, when I was growing up, 500 bucks actually got us a whole month's worth of water via a tanker. We didn't have water while growing up. You get it maybe once a week. So 500 bucks paid to bribe the water tanker guy to come to our neighborhood and give us water. So just, you know, 500 bucks. But what 500 bucks more importantly, or as importantly, does is gives ILAP the opportunity to have an attorney to represent a human being who's fled violence, persecution, intolerable pain that we sometimes cannot relate to, and at least gives them a leg up in the immigration process. That's what 500 bucks does. So, I want some $500 givers here. 500 bucks. Yes, thank you. So I'm gonna read out the numbers and then we're gonna thank them. 322. 137, 336, 187, 342, 346, 301. 171, 207. Woo! Thank you. This is just a lot of fun, I must say. Thank you, guys. This is so sweet. So sweet. So, another fun fact. This is actually a true story. When I was applying for my green card, actually, you know, in the old days, you had to go through multiple processes. And so you had to go through this visa, H-1B, everybody knows the H-1B process. Then you go through this O-Visa process, which I had to go through. So I was called for an interview at the JFK building in Boston because I wanted to now apply for my green card. So I went there, you know, yes, I've been here for the interview. So they say, well, we have a problem. I said, what's the problem? Well, we've lost your file. You've lost your file. And you're calling me over here and interviewing me? Why? Well, we have to tell you that now it's going to be another year and a half. Well, obviously, I lost my, you know. And but I had a colleague who knew a lawyer in these matters, made a bunch of phone calls. I had somebody talk on behalf of me to go in and say, we don't care if you lost the file. This man is not going to wait another year and a half in limbo. But that's what ILAP does. That's what people like ILAP do. They give us a voice in this Kafkaesque maze that don't be fooled. It's all online by now. It's an online maze of trying to make sense of things. So that's where ILAP comes in handy. Potentially, the other place ILAP also comes in handy is for people like me when we're going to Homeland Security and the guy runs my U.S. passport and has this look. And the reason is, my name is misspelled on so many different places that some time ago, actually, I was on the no-fly list. which makes for very fun entertainment. When your flight gets diverted to Rome and you're singled out to come and have an interview. Talk about 474 people really mad at you because somebody made a mistake somewhere and diverted the flight. So, but here's where ILAP comes in handy, because when something like that happens, we need support. We need somebody to listen to and say to us, I got your back, because now you are part of us. And the us makes us a whole. So, in that vein, we're now going to go to $300. And to kick it off, I pledge $300. Yeah. I have a number somewhere. 178. 178. That's actually, I was bribed to do that. No, I'm just kidding. Being Turkish and Pakistani, bribery, yeah, we know about bribery. So, $300, let's go. Otherwise, I'm gonna crank up. No, okay. Let's go. Rise, raise those hands. Let's read them off. 153, 240, 145, 155, 273, 305, 123, oh, they're pointing at each other, 167,
four.
You know, don't do that in Turkey, or in Pakistan. No, sir, in Pakistan, do not do this. That is bad, so don't. Oh, now you're really doing your show. Oh, good. Okay, Loretta. Come on now. Come on. Bob Barker got nothing on me. Nothing. So you need more. More. All right, I can't see. 313. Okay, we need more. I'm counting. I'll count it in Turkish. Bir, iki, üç. Okay, so we are in üç means... Three is in Turkish, is üç. So we need three more. Üç tane daha. Üç. We need to get to iki, which is two. We go countdown. Come on, guys. Yay. 312. That's serendipitous. 312, yes. 330. One more. One more. Okay, got it. One more. Oh, come on, guys, one more. You know, if I could tap dance, I'll do tap dance. Yes, 121. Yes, thank you. Everybody, thank you. Thank you for those. I was going to, well, I'm not going to say it. I was going to say something political, but I'm not going to. No. I'm not going to say it. Claude, where are you? Claude, did you donate? Where's Claude? Did he run away? Oh, these guys. All right, we have one more tranche to go. This is at 50, and we need to... $50. 200. 100. You know, your notes suck. That's what it is. I'm sorry, Laura. It's... ridiculous. I mean, no, I seriously, look, she gave me these things, you know, all the color-coded and all this stuff, and, you know, I mean, really, I'm a guy, seriously, and I'm a hybrid mutt. I'm a Pakistani, Turkish, American. I'm already confused, and you gave me these three colors? I mean, come on, seriously. All right, 100, 200, ikiyüz. 200. I mean, somebody's gonna beat me. All right, 200, let's go. All right, I'll read out the numbers. We got 275, 307, 326, 258, 244, 236, 162. Okay, hot dang it. I'm gonna do 40 push-ups to you guys, or I'll keep on doing push-ups. How many more do we need? Five, you did that again. Okay, we're doing. I'm doing push-ups till we get five more. Seriously, let's go. Five more! Let's go! Guys, I will die out here, I'm telling you! Just like Jack Palance. Do you remember Jack Palance? Yeah. All right. Let's go. I'm telling you guys, I will die out here, but I'm not gonna quit. Do we have five more? We got two more? One more, come on guys, jeez. I will not quit, you don't even, I came to this country with $200 in my pocket when I was 17 and a half, I didn't quit. I'm not gonna quit right now, so guys, come on. Let's go, one more. Guys, it's $100. 200, 200, do we have it? Yes? 211, 232, we got it? All right. Woo! All right. I have been prompted by my beautiful assistant that now it's 100. And for that, we need many, many, many. Many, 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 many. So let's do 100. I know you can do it. I know it. Come on. You guys got great food, good drinks, all that booze. You're going to have more booze later if you win the raffle. Let's loosen it up. All right, keep those hands up because I'm going to thank each and every one of you personally. Do we have them? Yes, 293, 346, 347, 188, 161, 290. 184, keep them up. 345, 249, thank you. 333? Oh, yes! We gotta go and play the lottery tonight. I'm telling you, you're gonna win some. 257, 111, 233, 170, 375, 150, 109, 154, 159, 241, 354, 267, 127, 180. Do we get them?
Yeah, we got them.
Woo! Okay. You guys haven't seen some funky dance moves. The thing is, you do the crossover, then go around. Remember the old James Brown days? And then he used to go on his knees. Where's the cape, guys? You didn't bring the cape? Oh, man. Okay. Loretta, next time, cape, please.
Okay, you got it, buddy.
Okay. Do we want to go more?
50.
Absolutely.
50 is the last level.
50 is the last level. And I'll tell you what 50 does. I believe one of the things that, you know, we say when we swear in, I feel like one of those Android. I'll tell you what $50 does. It gives our fellow human beings a chance to hold a job, to be able to vote, to have a voice, and to get preference when family members want to visit, because as United States American citizens, they get that preference. So before I ask you for your $50, I want to tell you a story. My dear mother has been coming from Turkey to visit us for the last 15 years. She's a sweet woman. But just like most immigrants and their families, they love to bring food, like fresh food, cheese, nuts, dates, you know. And for the last 14 years, she's been very fortunate that when she goes through immigration, they don't question her. They just, you know, sweet old lady, they'll say something. She's perfectly fluent in English, by the way. Perfectly fluent. She's like, I don't know English, I don't speak English. Oh, let's keep on going. Anyway, But last year, they said, no, you have to open it up. So she got interviewed for 3.5 hours. 3.5 hours. And you know, she loves to smoke. It's a long flight from Turkey. And so she said to them, I have to smoke. And they're like, you can't smoke here. And she said, I'm a 78-year-old woman. I've been smoking 3 packs a day for 45 years. I need to smoke. So they get agitated at her. And she says, you cannot be agitated at me. You're the same age as my son. And they say, who's your son? Kerem Durla. And they're like, oh, I think we know him. Oh. You know, because I've been nailed so many times at Boston. I kid you not, true story. Really, I'm going to keep it really short. But they ran my passport again. Before I knew it, 2 people came up to me, escorted me. If you've been on an international flight in Boston, if you go down to get your luggage, if you remember, your luggage, the carousel is here. If you look in the back, you see sheet metal. Like, you know, it's like a mirror. It's not. It's the underground HQ of Homeland Security. They open up just like in Star Trek. So they took me in, actually, and they interviewed me for 1.5 hours. Yeah. So it's really freaky. Anyway, coming back to my mother. So they said, what is in these wraps you got? She said, well, it's jam, fresh mulberry jam. What do you got over there? Fresh Turkish cheese. What do you got over there? Sausage. That's when they got, you actually brought sausage to the United States? He says, yeah, but my son loves Turkish sausage. And I don't know how she said that, but they took everything else but left the sausage for her. And so when she came out, she's really, really mad. I said, I'm gonna smoke, but here's your goddamn sausage. So that's what $50 gets us. Okay? Sausages. So, we need $50 from a lot of people right now so that I can get sausage. If you want Turkish sausage, by the way, I'm saying tulumba.com. Tulumba, T-U-L-U-M-B-A.com. So, $50, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. All right. All right. I don't think I need to unbutton anymore, but I may have to. Are you getting him? Or do you want me to say him?
Yeah, say him.
371. Woo! Yes! Woo! 174. 108. 114. 367. 113. 151. 255. 168. 179. 185. 209. The reason I can go is because I'm a huge Pearl Jam fan, and Pearl Jam fans are trained to do so. Are you a Pearl Jam fan? Woo! Yes. Yes. Anybody more?
Hey, Karam, guess what?
What?
We made the goal tonight.
All right! Everybody! Thank you. Hey, give yourselves an applause. Everybody, yes. Thank you. Thank you. Very special. My friend, where are you going? We're going to dance. We're going to dance. We're not done. We're not done. I haven't even had any wine. Wait a minute. Did I say thank you to you guys?
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you. You're welcome. It's so special. Yeah.
Thank you.
Again, thank you to these guys. Aplaube. Yes, what? I know, the kids want to come up. These darn kids. All right, so come on stage, guys. All right. So, you guys look good. Yeah, it's look good. So, they have something special for all of you. And I almost took a Madonna-like fall, which would have been pretty cool. But what are we going to say? Thank you. Hi, raise it up. Now do a little... I'm Turkish. We dance like this in Turkey. We do. I'm not lying. Great. So, are we going to do the raffle stuff? Yes. So, the raffle. I don't know if you guys have taken out. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much for volunteering. Thank you, guys, for volunteering. So, the raffle. All right, guys. So, have your tickets ready. If you have cloned yourself, what? Yeah, you coming too? Did you get a ticket?
No, I haven't to pull.
Of course you do. Come on over here. I'm just pulling your leg.
Okay.
All right. So our friend is going to help us pull some tickets. In the event you have cloned yourself and your true self is not here, you cannot win. So you have to be here to win. Or all the way down.
So
you pull one out and I read it out.
Each boxes?
From each bucket.
Okay.
Yeah, each bucket.
Okay.
Now, just like the Oscars, this has been approved by Price, Waterhouse, Cooper, and Libran for following certain procedures and avoiding conflicts of interest. That's not necessarily true. But I thought that these handsome people should deserve a hand of applause for not rigging the election on this one. So, you start. So this is for the humanities package. Pick the right number.
Okay.
All right. Everybody, get them out. 2, 4, 1, 0, 7, 7, 8. Yes? Is it real? We need to do a quality check. I'm just joking. Thank you so much. So she gets them from back there, right?
She has to keep her
ticket. Oh, I got it now. This is your copy.
So.
Now we have the cuddle up package. Oh, cuddle up. Cuddle up. Cuddle up. Aha! Ta-da-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Number is 2410428. Hey, stop clapping before it's announced. Hey! Woo! You get the cuddle up package. Okay, next one. Oh, this is a good one. Okay, this is a big beer package. All right, why don't you come up over here. Mix it up. Aha, new series. 2409712. All right. Awesome. First ever mustache man to win a raffle prize. Thank you so much. So you get to keep and she will guide you to your.
Yeah, all right.
Okay. Fine wine package. I believe that's what my wife used to call me. Like fine wine package. Definitely brand new series on this one. Brand new. I know. Well, that's why we're an immigration kind of crowd, you know? We like to mix it up. Just mix it up. 427-118. Hey, I'll read again for you. Woo, all the way in the back. Woo! I'm going to take care of you. What is your number? You know, both in Turkey and Pakistan, You know, national elections have been rigged just on the basis of pieces of paper. We did. So I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to take care of you. All right. So this is the main sports package. May you fare well in this endeavor. Okay. New series. 240. Is it close? 240? 240-9831. I got a pen. Do you need a pen? People have done worse with a pen. Yeah. I'm going to read it again, and then I will say the same number in Urdu and Turkish for, you know, multicultural effect. 240-9831, also known as Do, Char, Sifar, No, Art, Teen, Ek. Yes? You got it? All right. One more time. Oh, for verification, are we? Let me say it with a clipped British accent for clear Laurence Olivier articulation. 240-9831. All the way from Downton Abbey. All right, we'll take this as number. Woo! Hey, it's the Taco Trio guy! Yeah! Woo! Hey, hang on. I think there's a conflict of interest thing that we talked about. Like... Okay, last one. Wellness. Just like tonight, which has contributed to our overall wellness, this ticket gives you the key to wellness. It's huge responsibility. Huge. Yeah, you gotta win. I'm telling you, you gotta win. Okay, I don't know. I'm 2-4. Oh, 0-9-6-6-4-5. Ah! Yes! She is on her way to wellness. Woo! There you go. Thank you, brother. The travel safe, huh?
Okay. See you soon.
Yeah, thanks for everything. No, really enjoyed it.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Ah, ha, ha. So I hope everybody gets to enjoy those great raffle tickets. And I want to thank the volunteers, too. They did a great job. But more importantly, I'd like to thank everybody who screamed, ah! I mean, I love that. I just love it. All right. So I got two announcements to make really, really quick. There's actually a conference coming up on May 21st that's really important. It's called Empower the Immigrant Woman. It's in Hannaford Hall, and it's for and about immigrant women with a jobs forum in the morning and a gala in the evening. So try to get information from the desks over here to get some information, because it's a really important event. I don't know if you guys know this, but women make the world go around. So, they do. And on a serious note, there's actually a study that was released by the Gates Foundation talking about the importance of women in economic development in third world countries. I urge you to take a look at that. We know the importance, we just need to do a better job at it. Second announcement, and Loretta, I'm not gonna read all this because this is ridiculous. So. Important things. We know Peter, Paul, and Mary. We know them, right? Okay. So they have been kind enough that in June they're going to perform a concert, a benefit concert, where the proceeds will go to ILAP. That's in June, and it's called One Light, Many Candles. It's at the Congregation Beth Ham in South Portland. So it's a free event. They'll be a reception at the end of it. all to benefit ILAP. All the information is on their website, which is ilapmaine.org. If you type in some other crazy website, you know, go for it, but it's ilapmaine.org. And they asked me to thank everybody again in terms of Empire, Jewel of India, Taco Trio, the guys from Whole Foods for all this, all the good work that they did and fed us. So I want to thank all of you. I want to thank the volunteers. I want to thank ILAP for making me make some push-ups. But from the bottom of my heart, I thank you for making a difference in everybody's lives. Have a good night. Thank you.